emailed her coordinates to her parents. I put my hand on my chest and I was like, what? I set that tent up in the dark. Okay. Sexy guys.
Hello, gals, guys, and MB friends. Welcome back to our YouTube channel.
Welcome back.
Today we are filming part two of our love story. If you haven't seen the first part, go check it out. We're basically picking up where we left off when Sufi dropped me off at the airport in New York after we first met.
So even though Anjali and me were states apart at this point, we would still talk on the phone every day and we would FaceTime a lot. And after every phone call that we had, Anjali would try to convince me to come visit her in California. I liked her a lot at that point. I didn't know if I wanted to fly all the way out to California for just a girl.
Just a girl. Ouch.
Apart from all of that, Andrew was trying to convince me to come for Pride weekend. I went shopping with my friend. I happened to find a shirt that had a big rainbow on it. Underneath it, it said California. I bought it and I took it home. I clicked a picture of it and I sent it to Anjali and she responded with, book your flight. And so I did.
Yeah, I took it as a sign. When Sufi came to visit, I was really nervous to host her. I came home from work a little early one day and Sufi had just arrived from the airport. I made her a Mediterranean vegetable bowl, which if you've watched our other videos, you know about this bowl. That weekend, we spent Saturday morning going down to a flower market and picking out some fresh flowers for our hair. Super gay. I also got Sufi a bouquet of tulips. She later named one of her cats Tulip. Wonder why. And then that evening, we found our way to my favorite park in the city, and I didn't know what Pride weekend in SF was like just because it was my first Pride ever. So I took her to the park and we didn't realize that Dyke March was happening at the same time. We got there and we just thought of it as a happy coincidence. So we set up our picnic blanket, same picnic blanket from Bryant Park in New York. Sufi was reading me poetry from her favorite poetry book. I was writing in my bullet journal, probably about her. It was just a really wholesome, cute afternoon, and then we went and got ice cream sundaes afterwards.
It was a lot of fun.
Then the next day, of course, was the Pride Parade. We got all dressed up together. We had some friends who had friends in one of the corporate floats. SF Pride is very corporate. We marched all the way from the beginning of the parade down to Civic Center, and then we watched Kehlani perform, and we were convinced she's from another planet. It was just a very surreal day. It was a lot of great energy and a lot of sunshine, and it was really great that we got to spend it together. One moment that I specifically remember is I didn't want to take a picture with Sufi, because I was afraid that people would figure something out. So I had another friend who was in town and I had Sufi take a picture of the two of us and I didn't even give her photo credits because I didn't want people to know. I was so shy and so afraid that people would figure it out, but I subtly wore a tube top that had the Bi Pride flag colors on it.
I had no idea about that. She looked really cute. She wore purple flowers, like tiny purple flowers in her hair. After that trip, we had plans to meet each other again. We just didn't know when it would happen. So it just so happened that Anjali had a girls trip in Chicago, and Chicago and New York are really close in distance. I think it's like a 2-hour flight. Anjali texted me and was like, hey, I'm coming to Chicago this weekend. And I was like, wait, that's really close to me. And she's like, oh, do you want to come?
That's not what happened.
That's literally what happened. I may have crashed the girls trip, but I was still invited.
She totally crashed.
I was invited.
At one point, she literally texted me and was like, you know what? This is stupid. You're so close to me, and bought a plane ticket and then came the next day. Like, I don't know about an invite.
I'll show you guys the receipts.
Uh-huh.
I get off the plane and I get a text from Anjali. And for some reason, I had a knot in my stomach, but it was the good kind. And so I get off the plane and she's like, hey, can you hurry up and come here? I have to tell you something.
By this point, you know, Sufi and I had been talking pretty much every day for 3 months. I had been feeling like I had something important to tell her, but I really wanted to tell her about it in person. It was just one of those things where, like, whenever we'd hang up the phone, there was something on the tip of my tongue that I wanted to say to her. When she got there, I pulled her aside into my friend's room and I was like, I have to tell you something. And then I just looked at her and I was like, I love you. This is how she reacted. I'm just gonna scoot back. I think I just broke my bed doing that.
I put my hand on my chest and I was like, what? I never thought she'd say I love you first, right? Because we weren't even dating at that point. But right after she said I love you, I looked at her and I was like, do you want to be my girlfriend?
I don't know if anyone out there can relate to this, but I low-key panic when it's time to get into a real relationship. So my first thought was, oh my god, it's too soon. How could she ask me to be official already?
What? But I don't think she loved me. How was I supposed to respond to that?
So that was my next thought. I was like, I literally just told her that I loved her. I guess it's time. So after we spent a nice weekend in Chicago together with some of my friends, I had a business trip in Dallas for the week. So I went down there and I was actually supposed to go to Seattle the following weekend. I had a friend who lived out there and my brother lived out there. Sufi's birthday was actually on Wednesday. So I had pre-planned some surprises for her with her best friend, Sarwar. Basically, we had a bunch of gifts planned out that I had sent to his house ahead of time or that I had pre-ordered, and then he was gonna compile all of them together and drop them off to her on the day of her birthday. I ordered a customized paintbrush roll that was stamped with her artist tag, Sufi Sun. And I had a giant bouquet of flowers,
purple flowers,
that I had arranged by a local florist and dropped them off to the preschool that she was teaching at the time. All throughout the week, he was just trying really hard to convince me to fly to New York to surprise her for her birthday.
That's best friend.
I thought he was crazy because I was actually supposed to fly to Seattle to visit my brother, but my brother ended up making other plans, which made me really salty. I ended up deciding that maybe it would be a good idea to spontaneously fly to New York. Sarwar helped me scheme this whole thing. So I ended up changing my flight to Friday morning after my business trip. He came and picked me up from the airport. The problem is I was like kind of crusty. I really needed to wash my hair. So he actually took me to the gym. I went to wash my hair, do my makeup, get changed, get all cute and stuff. He went with the two presents and grabbed some balloons. Now the thing is, I had to convince Sufi that I was in Seattle. So what I did, this is some scheming stuff. I hope I'm not giving anybody bad ideas. What I did was I switched my location services from my iPhone to show my location from my brother's phone. So Sufi couldn't see my location in New York. She was like, oh my gosh, how was your flight? So then once I'm ready, we head over to the neighborhood where Sufi's preschool was. We walked over. I was so nervous at this point, but also at the same time, she was like texting me, I'm almost off of work, like, what are you up to? How's Seattle? How was your work in the morning? And then we stopped around the corner from the entrance, and Sarwar walks around to the front, says, hey, I'm outside. I have a surprise for you.
I had never worked on my birthday up until that point, and so I was also a little sad that I wouldn't be able to see my girlfriend on my birthday, but I was excited to hang out with my best friend. And so when he texted me, he was outside and he had a surprise. I knew why I was feeling nervous the entire day. I had butterflies. I see him and I'm like, hey, what's up? What are we doing? What's going on? Where's the surprise? Oh, it's on my car. Let's go this way, right? Wait, but I brought my car. Why did you bring your car? I'm walking. I have no idea what's going on. I don't know what to expect. He gives me the flowers. He started filming me. Okay, this is gonna be really big if he has his camera out. So I'm walking. I turn the corner. I'm like, what the fuck? I see Anjali just standing there and I lose my shit. I just stand there, drop all my things, and I'm like, wait, I was literally just texting you. I was gonna call you when I got home. Where I went to go celebrate my birthday with my friends. We actually have footage.
Should we drop that footage?
Yeah.
So she saw me, her jaw dropped, and she ran away from me. She backed around the corner and she was like, what? And she like dropped her bag and she was just like, a successful surprise. One, because the bouquet of flowers was bigger than her, which was what I intended. And two, she looked cute that day. I was low-key stressed that she would be mad because she didn't like get ready or put her concealer on in the morning or something like that. And then I'd get there and she'd be like, what? You should have told me that you were gonna be here. But lucky for me, my girlfriend looks cute every day.
I had a really nice weekend with Anjali. It was the happiest I had been in a while. And I think my friends could see that too. Anjali came to my other best friend, Abdul's art show with me.
Yeah, that was really fun.
Yeah. The best part was me driving Anjali to our hotel room and us just blasting the entire Mohabbate album on the way down and singing along to it.
Zinda rehti hai unki Mohabbate. Zinda rehti hai unki Mohabbate.
So the next time I see Anjali is when I fly out to California again, and this time she did something really romantic, which she did the time before too, but she planned the entire weekend for us. We went camping on a horse sanctuary and If anyone knows me, they know I love horses.
Yeah, this was actually like in response to her not being able to go horseback riding on her birthday weekend. Like, she really wanted to go, so I took her to the horse sanctuary.
So we drove down the PCH, which was mesmerizing. We stopped for some pictures too, and we saw the sunset a little bit, which made us kind of late to our camping trip, and so we had to set up all the, well, Anjali set up all
yeah,
the camping
equipment. Yeah, I was gonna say, I set that tent up in the dark.
Anjali set up all the camping equipment by herself because I had never been camping at that point, and so I just turned on the headlights and I was like, go do your thing, baby girl.
She was so stressed, honestly, about sleeping in a tent in the dark. She was like, it's okay, you don't have to set it up, we can just sleep in the car.
Yeah. I was like, the effort was enough.
I think the cool thing was, even though we were honestly really spooked while we were there, we kept hearing noise outside the tent and we were stressing out, we would poke our head out, honestly, to check if there was anyone around us. Yeah. Sufi thought there were horses that were running around our tent. I don't know what's up with her.
You thought the same thing.
No, I
you
thought
know what she did? Oh my god, literally. She emailed her coordinates to her parents. If anything happens to me, this is where you can find me. And I'm just there with my phone with no service. Are you gonna tell them I'm here with you too?
Like, what did you think? They were just gonna leave you there?
I don't know. I didn't know them at that point.
Basically, we would poke our heads out to see if there was anyone around or any horses around. We would look up and we'd just get lost in the stars. Yeah. Because they were so beautiful. If you go far enough away from the city, you can see the whole sky and it was gorgeous.
I cried looking at that sky.
My little poet baby. It was a really cool spot too. It was kind of scary driving in because we had to go through many gates to get into the sanctuary area. Some of them were actually ranch land where the horses were roaming free. So we would pull up to the gate and then all these horses would come to our rental car and start sniffing the top. They were towering above the car, like their bodies were even higher than the roof of the car. Yeah.
The next morning we got breakfast and we were heading down to Santa Cruz, and on the way I see a sign that says strawberry picking. I look over at Anjali and I'm like, hey, do you want to go strawberry picking? So I swerved my car and went around. We picked a whole bunch of strawberries. It was really fun and they were really yummy because it was peak season. They were natural, straight from the farm. We were picking them ourselves. And it's so funny, I'm really good at picking fruit, but Anjali likes sour things and I like sweet things. So all of the strawberries that she picked were all sour and all of the ones that I picked were all sweet. And so after that, we were super hungry, we were famished. And so we stopped to get tacos and those tacos were so good. After tacos, we finally got to the swimming hole.
Oh yeah, so basically in Santa Cruz, there are some areas along hiking trails where there are swimming holes. And so we stopped in a couple, we were like waiting in some, and then we set up shop and started painting. We worked on two different canvases together and it was really relaxing and really peaceful.
So you can imagine at this point, after all these adventures that we've been having, how hard it was to say goodbye to Anjali.
Yeah, it was getting harder and harder. So the next trip that Sufi made out was actually kind of an emergency trip because at that point I was really trying to come to terms with my sexuality and coming out to people. I was having a lot of anxiety, but what Sufi did is she flew out to visit me. Our relationship was getting very expensive at this point,
yeah.
But she came out and helped me deal with a lot of stuff. She helped me get my life together, clean up my room, which tends to be a disaster when I'm struggling with my mental health. She took me to the botanical gardens, which is where I volunteer sometimes. We sat in the redwood forest and we wrote in our journals together. She actually did this exercise with me later, which I found the other day when I was going through and cleaning some stuff up in my new apartment, where she had me write out how I was feeling in Sharpie in a big notebook. She also had me make a list of things that were making me feel anxious, and then she sat with me and talked me through each of them, asked me why I was feeling that way, gave me reasons why I shouldn't be so stressed about them, and it was really helpful. I'm really glad that she was able to be there for me. Another really fun thing happened that weekend.
Whenever I get a tattoo, it's really spontaneous. I just wake up and I'm like, hey, I'm getting a tattoo today. So I told Anjali, I was like, let's find me a female artist. I only get tattoos from female artists. I knew exactly what I wanted. I had explained my concept to Anjali and she was down to come with me. I didn't know what kind of font I wanted, but I just assumed if I went to the tattoo artist and told her what I wanted, she would be able to guide me. And she gave me this big book of fonts, and I was looking through them, and I was like, none of this works for me. I need help.
At this point, I was really into fonts in general because I had gotten really into bullet journaling. I don't know why, because she hadn't told me what kind of font she wanted, but just based on the design of the tattoo, I kind of knew what she might want it to look like. So I was like, give me a sheet of graph paper and I'll try writing out what I think you want. And it turned out to be exactly what she wanted.
I ended up getting a tattoo in my girlfriend's handwriting. So the funniest part was, the entire time that I'm getting a tattoo, Anjali's holding my hand, which I thought was really cute, but she's squeezing it so hard. And I'm like, are you hurting at this point or am I hurting? Now mind you, I love getting tattoos. I love the way that they feel.
Anyway, by this point, you know, we were finding that it was really hard to be able to be there for each other during our important moments when we were so far away from each other. So we started discussing the idea of having Sufi move all the way out to California from New York, which of course was a really big decision and a really hard one to make. There was a lot that went into that decision. So we're gonna make part 3 of our love story, and that's gonna be how we ended up deciding that Sufi should move to California and everything that went into that decision and how we prepared, and then how she actually got here, which is a whole story on its own.
The last part.
Last part of our love story. So thank you guys so much for watching. We have some other videos on our channel if you guys want to watch them. Otherwise, like,
subscribe,
comment!
We love you guys. See you soon. Bye!
Bye!
Did you actually break your bed though? You buffoon.